Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing of my new oxygen helmet, so stick around. Comes in this nice box. Let's open it up. I got this over the summer, so you know I've taken it out of the box a couple times, but I haven't done anything with it. So it's in a bag, and this is a main cord that connects this to your sled. So let's take it out of the box. All right, comes with a nice little cinch sack here. Keep it from getting scratched. Pull that off. We'll set the box aside. All right, so let's officially take the stickers off the shield and everywhere. So this is a large for me. You might need a bigger size. We're going to flip open the visor here, and we're going to drop down with this lever here, the sun shield. And they call this a garage up here. It heats the shield. So if you're ever riding with the shield down and it starts to get just slightly foggy, you just pop it back up for a couple seconds, pop it back down. Now, this is all just what I've heard. Haven't experienced it yet, but nobody's disputing that at this point. It looks like there's another one on the shield that we'll have to remove. So, looks like up in this corner, you peel that back there, and it's not really like a sticker, it's more like static cling. On, so there shouldn't be any adhesive or anything left on there to dispose of or clean up. And we got the light here in the back, so we're gonna peel that off. And this is the connection for the heated shield. Instead of having something connected to the actual shield itself, like most other helmets, it has a magnetic connection on the back, and then this can be incorporated into your desk key if you have a Skidoo, and I do because I got the link connection for it. So let me show you how that connects. So this came in the box, as I showed you. There we have it, and so this is the part that connects to the back of the helmet, and I'll show you that in a sec. This is your temperature control, low, medium, and high. And when you clip this onto your coat, that'll be right down there, and you'll be able to change those settings, on the fly. Maybe not while you're riding necessarily, but you know, you stop real quick and just couple clicks and you're back in business, set to where you want to be. And also this portion. So this you'll need if you don't have Skidoo E-Link. I do have E-Link, so this will connect right to the portion on the sled, and I'll show you that now. Just like on the helmet here, if you have the E-Link on your sled, or you can install it yourself, you could have it done. I had it done at the dealer before I picked it up. You'll have a connection like this. So the way that the helmet connects here, it also connects to your sled. So now you'll have something like this. Your desk key now looks like this. And even though that probably could connect here, it's designed to go on the sled, and then this goes to your desk post, and that'll be like one connection. And this cord is your tether as well. So you do away with the original desk post key combination This is your desk post key, but it's integrated now into the E-Link electric shield cord. And so you run the cord through the back of the helmet, down inside your coat, out the front of the coat, and you clip this onto the front of your coat. And then this connects to your desk post and the E-Link electric socket on the sled, and you're good to go. And it's got this little rubber flap. You just flip out of the way, and snap it in place, and you'll turn that, and bam, magnetize right on just like that, and connect this to your coat. This end, when it's connected to the helmet, like that, magnetized, and then the end with the heat control connects to your new desk post key, like such, and you connect that to the sled, like I said. You will only be using this cord that comes with the helmet if you have a traditional RF connection. One more cool thing about this new desk post and E-Link combo is this will be clipped onto your coat, and when you take your desk post off of your sled and your E-Link, you can clip it together, and then that just hangs like that from your coat, and you're good to go. You can put, you know, disconnect this part, and that's all that's hanging from your coat, and you put this inside your helmet, and you're good to go when you're not riding. If you're still wearing your helmet, obviously you don't have to disconnect any of this stuff. If you're just walking away from your sled, you just clip these two together and holds on. So it's pretty convenient and cool that they did that. So let's take another look all the way around the helmet. Shield down, shield up, visor down, and it's got this little tab here so you can actually use some leverage to unsnap the helmet. This helmet is very soundproof and airproof as far as like wind doesn't really get into this helmet, so it's really good. You can also get an optional light for this helmet that goes in this position, and then you just push a button and it'll have a light there. I think that's around $30 or $40. It has a built-in balaclava here, so to speak. Doesn't go as far down in the back, but from the what I understand, you don't need to wear a balaclava with this helmet because it is so warm. Some may choose to just to get the helmet to slip off of your head a little easier, because when you have your bare ears and everything all up in there, I've heard that, you know, if it's a snug fitting helmet, it could be a little tougher to pull off your head. So you know, use your own discretion. Looks like here, I'm gonna tuck this in and pull this stuff out here. We're gonna undo. This is the type of clasp that it comes with. It's the ratcheting type, so you pull up here and comes right out. These are, I believe, extra little ear muff pads that could go inside. So inside the helmet, you have these removable noise canceling earmuffs, and they're also used to put your communicator headphones in. So, and then they just Velcro right back in place. This so-called balaclava or chin curtain is fully removable, washable. I'm sure it's hand washable. I would not put that in the washing machine because this part here is all plastic and it is removed with it. So I would not put this in the washing machine. And very well insulated, very warm helmet. So I'm looking forward to using that this season. Get a couple more shots of this helmet. Just want to let you know that the next video coming up will be installing the communicator in this helmet, hopefully. pressed for time here, so that is the plan for the next video, so be looking out for that. I want to thank you for watching. Please check the links in the description. Go like me, Pasty Boy, on Facebook and Instagram. I'll see if I can find a link for the helmet online. And bet you guys can't wait for snow just like me. So we will see you on the trail. Take care.